We have gathered here to celebrate the achievement of Dr. Jinali.
And heartiest congratulations to Jinali. She deserves a big round of applause. I cannot express in words how much I am happy today standing here and congratulating her. So the graph is like rising from one batch to other. So in 2016 batch, we had one student who had under 300 rank. In 2017 batch, we have two students. We already have congratulated and interviewed one student, Dr. Shruti, who got INI CET 252 rank, and Jinali has beaten all that and got 242 rank.
I'm present here. I once again welcome you, ma'am, to your and our own SMBT family.
I take a great honor to introduce you all to Dr. Jinali Lalka, ma'am, who has secured AIR 242 in NEET PG 2024. And I would like to congratulate her on behalf of whole SMBT family.
I would like to start the interview with a very sweet question, that the first time when you saw the result that you got AIR 242, how was your reaction? How did you feel at that time, and what was your family's reaction towards it?
It was nothing like I'd imagined. So while in the preparation phase, I'd always thought, pata nahi kaisa hoga if I get a 3-digit rank. I don't know how it feels to finally achieve what you've wanted. But then when it actually happened, I had imagined it so many times that it became so normal for me ki theek hai, ye to hona hi tha. Because I had a fair idea based on the recall questions. I was expecting a good rank, but I had not imagined I'll get this good a rank. That whole day, it was just making sense of what had happened. And also, you know, talking to your friends, some of them had scored, some of them had not. So that day went by SAE. The next day when I started getting everyone's calls, Gosavi ma'am had called me, ki kya Jinali itna acha rank lata hai kya koi? Then everyone, all my relatives, all my friends, they started congratulating. Me and my family, we'd had a small party at our place. It all started happening, but then my mind found something new to worry about. Ki ab kya karu is rank ka? It is just a number yet. I don't think it'll be any useful if I don't make the right choice. I started exploring everything. Ki kya karu? Medicine karu? Radio karu? Dermat karu? All my days went by and that only. Maybe today is the only time that I'm talking about my rank and my NEET PG journey. Nothing can top it.
Ma'am, as we all know that every exam needs a different kind of preparation. And every students have their own unique way of studying it, be it competitive exam or university paper. So would you please like to enlighten us how you prepared yourself for the exams and what are the important points that should be kept in mind while doing it?
Okay, so I'll tell only about the NEET PG exam, because CBME curriculum I'm not aware about, and university exam, see, the concepts stay the same. You have to get your concepts cleared. You have to mug up stuff. There are some things that are very important. You need to triage. Important ones pehle, baki sab baad mein. And that works for university. See, as far as NEET PG is concerned, it is not a sprint, it is a marathon. And you have to keep that in mind. You cannot have just bursts of motivation. Ki haan, aaj bahut acha lag raha hai. You just do it for 10 to 12 hours a day and then next day nothing. You have to keep doing it every day, the same thing. So I had just gotten introduced to this world of StudyGram on Instagram. It is very nice. There's so much of it there. What I had followed is, for my drop year, I had divided the year into many parts. So first 100 days was my first revision. Uske liye I had used Marrow. Marrow ka rapid revision videos. Please, 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 if anyone is doing Marrow over here for your entrance exam, don't see the main videos. They'll just use up your time. University exams ke liye maybe they are useful, but for the exam you have to stick to revision videos. And if you're not fine with watching videos, you get bored, you can do revision notes. So I used to see those videos and notes mein I used to mark that. So first 100 days was first reading. Uske baad you half the days. Then 50 to 60 days mein your second reading. Then I gave INI sit in November. I was very confused, INI deni chahiye nahi deni chahiye, because my main aim was NEET always. So, but then INI CET gave me an edge. See, NEET paper this year was very tough. It was toughest of all the papers that have taken in the NEET PG history. And they wanted to mimic INI pattern, US Emily pattern. So INI pattern helped me crack NEET paper. See, generally NEET mein question, a subject like psych is not that important, but they had put psych ke 10 questions and I had not done psychiatry for NEET itna acche se. But the things that I had prepared for NEET, for INICT, they were very useful. See, these competitive exams, unfortunately, they decide your career in 3 hours. And you have to give everything you have in those 3 hours. And you cannot just practice that sitting at your home, in your comfort. You have to give competitive exams. You have to keep giving competitive exams for that. So I gave both November INI and May INI. And then January ke baad, when the exam got postponed, I did a small job after the exam at Pusan because I was very bored. And then getting back became tough because I had done only 2 revisions and first reading till November. And after that, reading the same thing again and again, it became boring. So you have to keep finding for new things to keep yourself interested. Devise a plan, stick to it. If you feel something is off, you can modify it, but don't go running towards everything. I did only from Maru, and I had Dr. Zainab Vora's free stuff that you find on Instagram, you find on Telegram. You can use that. One of the most important parts is GT, which you have to give periodically. I must have given some 14 to 15 GTs in the whole preparation phase. So every 2 weeks, tumhara preparation hua hai, nahi hua hai, give a GT. So you have to keep your MCQ practice, your GTs going on. You have to practice minimum 50 MCQs every day. That is the minimum. It can go to 100, it can go to 150, but not lesser than 50.
My personal question will be, ki considering I am done with my first year and second year MBBS, there are some subjects which I myself find it hard. So it is hard, that's why I pull myself from it, ki mujhe nahi padhna hai, or else I just don't get that motivation to read those subjects. There might be some subjects which you find hard or you did not like it compared to the other subjects. So at that time, how did you push yourself? I mean, read those subjects or revise those subjects?
So university mein to tumhare paas option hai nahi, because you have to pass that subject, so wo padhna hi hai. NEET PG mein there's a bias because there are 19 subjects and there are 200 questions. See, but how these exams work are, they have to make 200 questions in 19 subjects. And they have to include a minor subject like psych and radio also, and a major subject like medicine, gynec and surgery also. So what they do is integrate the topics. They'll give a clinical scenario where you'll understand the diagnosis by studying medicine or surgery. But then they'll suppose the answer comes out to be hookworm infection or diarrhea. So then they'll give hookworm X to identify. So uske liye you'll have to do micro also, you'll have to do medicine also. Or they'll ask some question from medicine and then they'll ask something about a drug and the side effect of some drug. That, for that you'll have to study pharmac also. So you can't skip any subjects. Even if you don't like it, you have to do it. There's no other option. You'll have to find ways to make it interesting. For me, ANAT was a bit tough for me. So I found YouTube videos. I found cadaveric dissections. I explored many teachers for that. So, but then you have to make it interesting. You just cannot skip anything. So I'll just say stick to one source. There are some subjects which are not good in Maro, some are not good in Preparator. Don't keep buying everything. Just find some alternatives for those subjects.
Ma'am, talking about online platforms, initially when I started watching videos on the online platforms, I found that ki matlab theek hai, video dekha, kaam khatam. But later on, I found ki matlab there is a huge difference between video watching and reading textbooks. So how to bridge this gap?
I really don't understand how can you all use online platforms for university exam. See, I was someone who always stuck to standard textbooks. If I had time, I had read the whole Robbins. But I'd made sure all the important topics like the cell injury part, inflammation part, I'd done from Robbins. And it was so interesting. And then Ramdas Naik, which is the copy of Robbins. So you have to stick to your textbooks. Your videos won't help you crack university. Okay, they'll help you get your concepts cleared. But answers likhne ke liye, you have to have matter. NEET PG is concerned, I am someone who wants to hear it from someone else. Someone teaches me something and then only I'll understand it. So I watched revision videos. And then I made, for some subjects, I made my own notes. And then for the subjects, there were printed notes from the rapid revision series. So I used to underline that or add something else what the teacher had said. Then I used to solve PYQs, previous year questions. They tell you what things are important in those particular subjects, what topics are very important. Then I used to solve those PYQs and I used to annotate them. That means add them in your notes. So I used to have a very concise matter of everything, what the teacher has told, what there's printed in it, and then the matter from those questions. Theek hai, video dekhna is fine, but you have to read your textbooks in your MBBS. You have to make your base strong, and preparation year mein agar base strong hai to hi tum aage badh paoge. Basic hi clear karte baithoge to you won't get time to read something extra, and things like INICET and NEET, they ask extra things which are maybe not important for your clinics. But since the exam is competitive, they ask relevant stuff. Uske liye time banane ke liye you have to keep your basics strong, and uske liye textbooks are very important. Videos, they take up a lot of time, but if you want someone to tell it to you, you can watch those ones. And bahut bar padhte padhte bhi bore ho jata hai, so you have MCQ videos. So they even teach you how to solve your MCQs. Usme bhi extra concepts aa jate hai ki rule out kaise karna hota hai, rule in kaise karna hota hai. Bahut sare questions mein you just are not aware of topic, but aaju baju ka thoda pata hai to usme se kaise nikalna hota hai. So you can watch MCQ videos also. So you have to have a balance between both of them.
So right now when we are in MBBS, so abhi hum kya kare, what steps we should take in MBBS UG days that will help us in the long term?
This is one thing that I would stick to, that nothing competes your MBBS ka preparation. I knew I had an edge because I had good foundation. We had PCTs in ANAT, biochem, everything. Tab bhi bahut lagta hai ki ye kyu de rahe hain. But then that made a foundation ki my concept, I knew that I don't have to revisit those again. So MBBS mein apna, I am not telling pure din padhte baitho, but jo pad rahe ho usko sirf Bhalani se ya Unique se mark karke mat padho. That is the worst way to study. You should know what are the important topics, but uska sirf aise mat karo ki question hai, uska sirf answer par. पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट पढ़ो. वंस यू डन विद द होल कॉन्सेप्ट, यू विल स्टार्ट इंटीग्रेटिंग एवरीथिंग बाय योरसेल्फ कि हाँ फिजियो में ऐसा पढ़ाया था, उसका पैथोलॉजी ऐसे निकलता है, उसका ट्रीटमेंट फार्मैक में ऐसे होता है. And that you'll only do if you've not skipped the major part. सब तो कवर होने ही नहीं वाला, but you cannot skip the important topics. So I won't say start preparing for NEET PG in your MBBS. Please don't, you will regret. Don't start preparing for NEET PG. Don't your Zainab Bohra ki videos or what do we say, or your high-end topics abhi se, because they won't be useful. You won't remember them last tak and university mein aega nahin. But jo university mein aane wala hai, us question answer ke jaisa mat padho. Read them like a story, or explain it to a rubber duck. You know, I used to use this rubber duck method where there is something that I have to explain it to like a teacher. And then I'll only make questions ki isme sabhi kya kya pooch sakte hain. Revision bhi ho jata tha, concept bhi strong ho jata tha, and this thing actually helped me carry it onto the preparation phase also.
Ma'am, there is a very nice saying in Hindi that doodh ka jala hua chhas bhi phook phook kar peeta hai. So were there any kind of mistakes while doing your preparation, and you would like to advise everyone out here, well, not to repeat those?
One mistake that I feel was very relevant to this year's paper was I stuck a lot to PYQs. So I was so much on NEET PG ka paper pattern that theek hai, there will be only single liner questions, there only be questions that need to be rectified, like identify the egg of this this organism, or what is the IPC code for this law, or what is the color of hypostasis. They'll ask such questions only, one word, one liner question. But what they did was they made whole clinical scenarios, they made proper diagnosis, and then we were asked to comment on the complications or the treatment or something like that. And that was kind of disappointing, because this is what happens in INICET. They ask you big clinical scenarios, they ask you expansive questions jisme se aadhi cheeze are not relevant. So they had done that, and it came as a shock for everyone. I was lucky that I was in the second shift, सो आई कुड आस्क पीपल फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट शिफ्ट की पेपर कैसा था. आई वेंट मेंटली प्रिपेयर्ड कि पेपर खराब आने वाला है विच इज मोर टफ. सो डू नॉट रिलाय टू मच ऑन कि हाँ नीट तो ऐसे ही रहेगा, नीट तो ऐसे ही आएगा. बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द वर्स्ट.
Is there a system, a smart system for preparing for NEET PG?
Yeah, of course there is. So, like I told you, triage. You have to see all your PYQs, all your previous year questions. You have to judge कौन से questions important है. See, first off, NEET PG, as I had always thought ki it is a clinical exam, no? So, medicine, surgery, OBGY, ये सब ज़्यादा पूछना चाहिए. But since it is a competitive exam and since you're giving it after your 5 years of MBBS, they ask questions from first and second year. There is a saying कि those who just do the clinical subjects they get rank in thousands, first 10,000 or something. Those who do second year subjects they get rank in first 1,000. But those who are good at first year subjects, they get rank in first 100. And that stays true.
Some of the students sitting here, matlab their aim is to crack NEET along with the internship. So how should they proceed?
See, as far as your final year is concerned, you have CVME, you have your ENT, ophthalm and all your four subjects over here. So NEET ko dekho bhi mat. Stick to university. Lekin jo ye six subjects here, your ENT, ophthalm, surgery, gynec, medicine and peds. So stick to those six subjects. Lekin uska itna sab kar lo ki internship mein wapas dekhne ki zarurat na pade. To uska sab kuch kar lo. And then in the internship, work on your first and second year subjects. Your patho, pharmac, micro, FMT, community medicine and physio. And time mila to anat, biochemistry. So work on those subjects, okay? Jo first 100 days rakhe revision ke, wo uske saath karo. Now those 100 days can collide with anything. It depends on your posting. Even major posting mein bhi agar OPD mein baithe ho, कभी कोई पेशेंट आया नहीं है, कीप सॉल्विंग इट एंड वी हैड पीपल डूइंग इट एंड दोज आर वेरी यूजफुल बिकॉज यू आर मेकिंग यूज ऑफ योर टाइम. एंड कुछ देने के पहले दो रिविजन तो करो ही 30-30 डेज के. सो एक रीडिंग हो गई आपकी सब सब्जेक्ट्स की, दो रिविजन में आपने जो फाइनल ईयर के सब्जेक्ट्स की उसका सिर्फ रिविजन कर लिया. एंड थर्ड रिविजन में सब सब्जेक्ट्स का सिर्फ जो टॉपिक्स आपने इंपॉर्टेंट मार्क किया है. सी एवरी टाइम यू वॉन्ट बी रीडिंग एवरीथिंग. अभी एक चीज़ पढ़ी है उसमें यू हैव मार्क्ड समथिंग कि हाँ इतना चीज़ है जो मुझे नहीं आता और आई नीड टू रिवाइज दिस, क्योंकि कॉन्सेप्ट बार बार रिवाइज करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती, जो चीज़ रटना है वो रिवाइज करना पड़ता है. सो यू हैव दीज थिंग्स कि आपको इतने सारी चीज़ें, इतने सारे ड्रग्स का इतना सारा साइड इफेक्ट पढ़ के रखना है. यू मेड अ टेबल ऑफ इट, बस नेक्स्ट रिविजन में से उसको ही रिवाइज करो. नोट्स को हर एक रिविजन में कंसाइज करते जाओ. फर्स्ट रिविजन में अगर तुम्हारी बुक इतनी बड़ी है, नेक्स्ट रिविजन में इतनी छोटी हो ही जानी चाहिए. फ्लिपिंग दोज पेजेस, हर एक चीज़ तुम्हारे आंखों के नीचे से जानी चाहिए कि हाँ मुझे ये आता है, ये आता है, ये आता है. इतना भी अगर तुमने कर लिया इंटर्नशिप तक, भले ही सब कुछ पिटपाट नहीं है, बट अगर 10 डेज का रिविजन तुमने कंसाइज कर लिया है ना, यू विल गेट अ गुड एनफ.
मैम, इन योर ऑल द आंसर्स व्हाट वी हाइलाइटेडली नोटिस दैट यू केप्ट ऑन सेइंग कि GTs देना है या फिर PYQs देना है. तो एंड इवन यू सेड दैट देयर वर 100 डेज व्हिच यू डिवाइडेड. तो इन दोज 100 डेज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स डज अ स्टूडेंट हैव टू सॉल्व द GTs एंड हाउ फ्रीक्वेंट इट शुड बी?
सी सो द स्टार्टिंग 100 डेज व्हेन आई हैव जस्ट डन माय फर्स्ट शेडिंग, तब GT थोड़ा लेट स्टार्ट किया चलेगा. स्टार्टिंग के एक महीने के बाद तुमने GT चालू की तो ठीक है. एज योर रिविजन गोज ऑन यू हैव टू कीप इंक्रीजिंग योर GT का फ्रीक्वेंसी. इट शुड बी देयर फॉर एवरी अदर वीक, मतलब एवरी 15 डेज में एक GT तो होनी चाहिए. सो एवरीथिंग दैट हैज टू गो रॉन्ग विल गो रॉन्ग इन दिस ईयर एंड दिस आई कैन नॉट स्ट्रेस इनफ. आई हैव सीन डेथ्स, आई हैव सीन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, आई हैव सीन and it is all very stressful. So there is one thing where they say you have to remember your why. Tum kyu kar rahe ho ye? For me it wasn't getting a seat or getting a rank or getting a dream branch. It was I don't want to regret this later like I did for my UG. You have to take scheduled breaks. For me Sundays were a complete no to studying. ठीक है, GTs देती थी मैं सुबह को, but after that 2 or 3 o'clock जब GT हो जाती थी, I used to just lie down and do nothing. MBBS में you have your roommates with you, you have your friends with you who become your family. You have 24 hours you have people around you. घर पे जाके अकेला लगता है, because you have changed, your family is the same, so you kind of take time adjusting back into the city. See, मेरे लिए इतना difference नहीं था मुंबई नासिक का, but still it took me 6 months to get readjusted back into Mumbai. So उसका stress होता ही है. तो you have to be your own cheerleader. कि ठीक है, you're doing good. होता रहेगा and please take breaks.
Thank you, ma'am, for coming here, for mentoring each and everyone here. I hope that everyone takes your advice, inculcates in their own study, and so that even the people who are sitting on the at that side will come here and someday give an interview like you.